In Brevard County, Florida, a 7-year-old Down syndrome girl had her mask taped onto her face using nylon rope. This was school officials that did this. It happened every day for 6 weeks, and her parents were never informed, were never given a choice, none of that. Eventually, the school officials got so used to doing this, to abusing the child in this way, that they sent her home with the mask still, you know, tied to her face using nylon rope because they wouldn't want her to be able to remove it. This is a non-vocal child who doesn't speak, can't speak, and thus they feel especially comfortable abusing in this way. And so they sent this little girl home with the mask taped on, and obviously the parents were outraged, as they ought to have been, frankly. This isn't the only instance of it happening. I keep hearing these reports from all over the country. In Colorado, there's a Chinook middle school where they've been using tape to literally tape the masks onto the faces of the kids. Now, what you might think I'm going to say, the more obvious thing is, well, we shouldn't have mask mandates in the first place on little kids, and, you know, questions about the different virus and how it affects kids and all that. Okay, there are some valid points to be made there, but more importantly to me is the fact that this kind of points to the fact that these schools see a sense of ownership that they have in regards to these kids. That's what they see. The kids that you send to a public school are their property for them to do with as they like. And I think this kind of illustrates that really well. That, you know, there's this effort to sort of hide a certain thing from their parents. And we saw it during the COVID saga, when you had actual teachers having these conversations about how they weren't sure how they were going to teach things like, you know, conversations about race and sex when the kids were at home and a parent might overhear. And it's like, well, if the parent overhears, why would the parent have a problem with education? Well, it's because they're not educating, they're indoctrinating, and they're treating your kids like they belong to the state. And that's what we're seeing in these cases, is a sense of ownership being really manifest in a way that there's no appreciation for parental rights or obviously for basic decency either. And I really think people should spend a lot of time, like, yes, there are these different parents who are going to school boards, and honestly, you know, Godspeed to them, who are trying to start a fuss about some of the things that are wrong with the teaching of critical race theory, with the mask mandates and all of this. But I think there's something that you ought to think about before you send your kids to public schools, if it really is any option at all, because you're handing over your kids as property in the eyes of the teachers and employees of the school district, because that's how they see it. They see it as they're taking over. They're not trying to, you know, teach your kids the moral messages, for example, that you would. They don't have any regard for that. They're trying to teach them the moral messages of the state, if they can be called moral messages at all.